Jason Schwartzman often helps with the writing of Wes Anderson's films. And off we go. So we have to get everyone sorted out into the right order. The protocol must be respected. There with Wes Anderson, Tom Hanks, Damien Bonnard, the French actor in the crew.
Scarlett Johansson, Jason Schwartzman, et Tom Hanks.
This is Wes Anderson's 12th feature film. Wes Anderson loves Actor Studio, and in the film there's one scene with a character who has to announce to their children that their mother is dead, and he's finding it rather hard. So let's try and act out that scene. So I suggest that you start. Let's let that drop. We'll do something else. Let's just watch the stars, shall we, on the screen. Tom Hanks, Oscar-winning actor. Do you recognize the music in the background there? The Last Train to San Fernando. In the film that you saw, the animated film, is there any stop motion? Well, Wes Anderson loves that technique of stop motion. Right from childhood, he would put on puppet shows, he'd build the set, the costumes, all of the accessories. And he's a perfectionist. He's quite a maniac about the details. He wants everything to be perfect. He sketches out and he times the scenes upstream. And he likes to be out in the elements filming, in the rain and the wind, etc. He's obsessed with trains, a bit like Hitchcock was, and a bit like Melville was, filming model trains, for example, and making people believe that they were real trains. And Wes Anderson exhibits his sets as theatre pieces. And Wes Anderson admires Brando, James Dean, that kind of epoch. Wes Anderson said that there was such a strong emotion in the films by those characters and also by their work in the theatre. He's a theatre buff, is Wes Anderson. Wes Anderson's film is broken down into acts, if you like, in scenes. So it will be released in the month of June here in France. So you don't have to wait too long to go and see it. So if you don't catch it tonight, if you're not a lucky person at the world premiere screening, you can catch it in France later on. And you'll see that the structure is that of a play. It's in scenes and acts. And also in the film, you go behind stage in a theatre. There's lots of Martians and asteroids in the film as well. So that's exclusive information here. And if you can't watch Asteroid City tonight, why don't you try and get your hands on Isle of Dogs? That was Wes Anderson's animation film, available in French or in English. There's Adrian Brody, who we know from The Pianist, film by Polanski, a Golden Palm in 2002. Wes Anderson has made Rushmore, The Royal Tenenbaums, The Life Aquatic, Grand Budapest Hotel. These are films filmed on film. They're not digitally filmed. They've got pastel colours. The sets and the costumes are really detailed and carefully thought out. The shots are all very symmetrical. One of the questions to be addressed in the film is, how does one cope with mourning when someone dies? How do you go through that mourning phase? So you said that Wes Anderson came to Cannes previously with a pink shirt on, but now he's only wearing a boring white one. There we have Scarlett Johansson. She's already worked with Jonathan Glazer, who's also in competition this year. And at that time, it was Under the Skin, Scarlett and Jonathan Glazer. So alongside Scarlett, there was Matt Dillon. And there's some dancing going on down there. Rupert Friend is dancing with Maya Hawke. As I said earlier on, Maya Hawke is the daughter of Ethan Hawke and Uma Thurman. And she acts in Stranger Things, the very successful series for teenagers and older teenagers, just like ourselves. What an amazing crew, a constellation of stars in Asteroid City. Wes Anderson took inspiration from 2001 Space Odyssey, for example, and there are some references to Close Encounters of the Third Kind by Spielberg. There's a bit of chaos out there on the red carpet. All of these actors on the red carpet, all of them edging towards the movie theatre, which is full to the brim. This film is in competition. It's hard for such a film to pick out the single roles, the different roles. They're all amazing actors and actresses. They've got all more or less the same number of minutes on the screen. Perhaps Scarlett Johansson has a few more minutes than everybody else. There's Tom Hanks there, Maya Hawke, Wes Anderson, the actor from Breaking Bad. Wes Anderson has whipped out his phone. Oh, there are several of them have whipped out their phones, ready to take photos or perhaps to film. They'll keep some nice souvenirs. There's Tom Hanks with his souvenir. I thought it was forbidden to take selfies and stuff on the red carpet. Yeah, but when you're so famous, I'm sure you can be allowed to. They're not taking selfies anyway, they're taking photos of everybody. So an amazing cast in this Wes Anderson film. Jason Schwartzman, Scarlett Johansson. There's Bryan Cranston from Breaking Bad. There's Tom Hanks, Steve Carroll, Adrian Brody, Jeffrey Wright, Rita Wilson, Damien Bonnard, our French actor, Maya Hawke, Matt Dillon, Willem Dafoe, Jeff Goldblum. They're all in the cast. They've all got time on screen to say some wonderful words and lines. In fact, the action takes place at a convention of junior stargazers and space cadets. But something happens that disrupts the world events. So that's the pitch. A Martian Walker gets out of its spacecraft. Everybody raises their eyes to the sky, looking up as one does when one's at the movies, looking up to the screen. This city, this asteroid city is amazing. Are they taking a selfie there? Where's Thierry Frémaux in all this? Perhaps he's scooting to the festival hall as we speak. No, there he is. I can see him on the screen. Thierry Frémaux. That's a selfie, if ever there was one. There's Alexandre Desplein behind Tom Hanks, French music composer who's won many, many Oscars. There we have Tom Hanks waving wildly. Here we have the entire crew from the film Asteroid City. What a team, what a crew, what a cast. Tom Hanks, Scarlett Johansson, all the rest of them turned up in a bus, in a coach, in fact, which looks as if it dated from the 1950s because that's when the action in the film takes place. The action takes place in the desert. Wes Anderson has made a move back to independent films since 2021, working with the French Dispatch. Adrien Brody was in that, Tilda Swinton, Léa Seydoux, and many other French actors were in that as well. But this year, Damien Bonnard is the member representing the French actors and actresses. So there we have the director, Wes Anderson. I think it's time for us to leave them now. We'll be back for another red carpet at 10 p.m. Here we have Asteroid City in competition.
Let's hear it. Let's hear it. It's movie time. Here's Jason. Here we go.
Man of the hour.
Here we go.
You can start.
Should we sit?